January 1886. Piano examination, Paris Conservatoire. Examiner's comments. Insignificant and laborious. June, second examination. Examiner's comment. Worthless. After leaving the conservatoire, Satie looked for work playing in the cabarets. The first time he visited the Chat Noir, he presented himself to its sharp-tongued director as a gymnopédiste, a meaningless term. Language inspired him. He published three gymnopèdes in beautiful new harmonies. His brother said the Christian idealist spent hours in the gloomy light of Notre Dame. Claude Debussy met him playing in the Chat Noir and became friends. They met once a week for 25 years, and together with Ravel, Debussy came under Satie's influence, admiring his consistent revulsion for the fashion, for Wagnerian grandiosity. How do you like your epic? Obese or lean? Simple, short or ugly? Their pared-down music generated a new materiality, the substance of music. Satie was a café-dwelling bohemian, the only man who made Brancusi laugh. Louise Varez noted, "The most mischievous eyes I've ever seen behind crooked pince-nez." He joined the Rosicrucian sect, led by priest-king Peladan. He loved their Gregorian chant and plainsong, then bored, created a church of his own, l'Église Métropolitaine d'Art de Jésus Conducteur. His abbey was in the Rue Courtois, below his flat, a square-tiled bare room with a pipe carrying dirty water running right through it. Satie's one epic, Vexations, haunts two lines of music for 840 repetitions, riffling through sunrise to sundown and further. Gavin Bryars calls it a sort of ring de Nibelungen de Pauvre.
I'll play Vexations one day, repeated as instructed. After all, he wrote,
"I've never written a note I didn't mean. The haunting piece rejects conventional harmony." John Cage recalled,
"The experience over the 18 hours and 40 minutes of those repetitions was very different from the thought of them, or the realization that they were going to happen. For them to actually happen, to actually live through it, was a different thing. What happened was that we were very tired, naturally, after that length of time, and I drove back to the country. I slept an unusually long period of time, and when I woke up, I felt different than I'd ever felt before. And furthermore, the environment that I looked out upon looked unfamiliar, even though I had been living there. In other words, I had changed, and the world had changed."
Vexations was written after a passionate affair with the painter Suzanne Valadon, the only known love of his life. His music is short, melodic. Subtle variations occur with repetition. They are musical koans, much abused by the advertising industry. Cocteau said,
"Satie gave comic titles to his music in order to protect his works from persons obsessed with the sublime. Veritable flabby preludes for a dog. Sketches and exasperations of a big boob made of wood. Pieces shaped like pears. Après-midi of a sea cucumber. And desiccated embryos."
He moved out to Arcueil, cut his long hair, spoke slowly and intensely, became a hermit, stayed an outsider in the cabarets, a poor musician walking home every night, hammer in pocket for protection. His ambition was to avoid the sun, venture out in his grey velvet suit, only on cloudy days, and eat pale food. He forged music on a diet of eggs, sugar, shredded bones, animal fat, salt, coconuts, rice, turnips, pastry, cheese, white, cotton salad, and white fish. Forerunner of Cajun minimalism, he's more influential than Wagner.